today is Exodus 15 to 20. And the title of today's message is Laying Down the Law. Good morning, everyone. I hope that you guys know that you are in presence of God, that you worship your Almighty God, and God is with you at the moment. And as our call to worship said, we are called to worship God and give Him praise Him with our spirit and soul and mind and body. So I want you to give your full attention to our God who made us and who called us to His presence. Let's pray one more time to receive today's message. Let's pray. Father, thank you for giving us another year of 2021. It is another chance that you had allowed us. Father, as we have entered the new year, let us continue to grow and mature in our spirituality and in our mental and also physical body. Father, let us grow in love of you and a passion towards you. Thank you once again for calling us as your sons and daughters. And thank you for giving us your holy words to us. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. For 3 months, the Israelites saw the glory of God and how God, with his powerful hands, delivered them, the Israelites, out of the land of Egypt to the land of wilderness. Exodus 13, 21, 22 says, God led them by day in pillar of cloud and by night in a pillar of fire to give them light. By the righteous right hand of God, God let the Israelites pass through the Red Sea, but wiped out the Egyptians by the water. Then Moses made Israel set out from the Red Sea and went into the wilderness of Shur. Let's turn to Exodus chapter 15, verse 25 to 26.
There, the Lord made for them a statute and a rule. And there he tested them, saying, if you will diligently listen to the voice of the Lord your God, and do that which is right in his eyes, and give ear to his commandments and keep them all his statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you that I put on Egyptians, for I am the Lord, your healer.
Amen. So at the wilderness, God started to test and begin his training for his people Israel. First, God tests them with thirst and hunger. And both times the Israelites complained against God, forgot that God was powerful God who delivered them out of Egypt, who had power to destroy his enemies. They forgot that and they continued to complain against their God and their leader Moses. But God still gave them water to drink and sent them manna, the bread from heaven, and the quail to feed them. God's test on Israelites continued. He wanted to see if they were ready to receive his instruction and his law and obey his word as God's people. 3 months after leaving Egypt, the Israelites enter the wilderness of Sinai. As Moses went up to meet God on the Mount of Sinai, God called down to him from the mountain and told Moses to deliver his law, his message to his people of Israel. Exodus chapter 19. So turn to four chapters and Exodus chapter 19, verse 3 to 6. I'm going to go ahead and read verse 3. Thus you shall say to the house of Jacob and tell the people of Israel, Exodus 19, verse 4, you yourself have seen what I did to the Egyptians and how I bore you on eagle's wing and brought you to myself. Now, therefore, if you will indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession among all people, for all the earth is mine. Verse 6, and you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. And verse 8 says, all people answered together and said, all that the Lord has spoken, we will follow, we will do. Then God gave Moses the list of the laws by which the Israelites should live. And those laws were called the Ten Commandments, which in Hebrew words is called God's Word. Ten words. Following is the Ten Commandments. That's written in Exodus chapter 20. First, you shall have no other God before me. Second, you shall not make yourself an idol. Third, you shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Fourth, remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Fifth, honor your mom and dad, your father and your mother. Six, you shall not murder. Seven, you shall not commit adultery. Eight, you shall not steal. Nine, you shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. And 10, you shall not covet anything that is your neighbor's. God spoke these 10 words to his people in a loud voice from out of fire and cloud and deep darkness. When the people saw the thunder and the lightning and the sound of trumpet, loud trumpet, and the mountain smoking, they were so afraid of their powerful and mighty God that they begged Moses to speak for them. Go towards God and speak for them. So Moses went up to the mountain to receive more specific laws and decrees and instruction from the Lord. On the Mount Sinai, God laid down his expectations for his people to live a holy life on earth. And God provided the 10 words to keep his people safe, unified, and focused on their relationship with him. We've learned 10 commandments throughout our Christian life. If you were Christians since you were young, you've learned 10 commandments. You've heard 10 commandments. These 10 commandments, these law and instruction from the Lord, however, was not a simple judicial system. Through the law, God was defining his relationship with his people. Once again, by giving the 10 laws or 10 words, God was defining his relationship with his people. This means the 10 commandments were not just a moral, social, civil laws. If anyone in U.S., whether citizen, residents, or non-citizen, breaks the Constitution of the U.S., they get judged and they get punishment. And after they pay their punishment, that's it. They're done. There is no such thing as, oh, I broke my relationship with the country, United States. But God's law, the Ten Commandments, was a rule from God, who is the owner of the whole land, entire land, for the people who is tenants for his land, on his land, to live a holy life by having and by deepening the relationship with God. The Ten Commandments is the essential for anyone and everyone who has faith. And if anyone calls himself or herself as a person of faith, but not having or living out these words of God, that person is not walking with the Lord. And is not there, the person is not true person of faith. And eventually, if that kind of life continues, not worshiping God, creating idols, and putting God's name down, not honoring their parents, and also other adults and leaders of faith, and lying, and complaining, and so on, he or she will be cut from the relationship of God. On the other side, if anyone calls oneself as a person of faith and living out these word of God, keeping these laws, that person will be forever God's people, forever God's child, and God will be their God, the person's God, who loves and cares, protects, leads, and provides. Also, the Ten Commandments bring out God's character to light, meaning By keeping these laws, we discover who our God is, what our God's characteristic is. For example, from the Ten Commandments, we see God values loyalty, faithfulness to God. Compared to Egyptian gods, or how Egyptian people worship their gods, they had thousand gods. And what that means is they thought their gods were okay for having other gods. The gods of Egypt were okay for dividing those worship to other gods. But our God is one and only God who did all creation, who gave blessings, who protects them, who saved them, who loves them, who care for his people. And God values loyalty from his people. Another thing is that God values holy, God-like, Christ-like life from his people. We see from the Ten Commandments 5 and on, our God is not God who kills and murders. God is not one who commits adultery. God doesn't steal. God does not bear false witness. God does not lie. God does not complain and covet or being jealous of other people's things, their possessions. Jesus Christ lived that life. Jesus, our God, lived a life who did not murder, who did not commit adultery, and all that. So through Ten Commandments, we see God values holy life from his people. And lastly, we also see that God also values life with other people. A lot of religions, other religions, put focus on individual and their worship, their relationship with their idol, their God. But our God also values, as much as he wants us to worship him, he wants us to serve other people, love other people. And that is a way of also worshiping our God. These 10 words from God are timeless, and it's still valid for you and me, who are now called a new chosen and holy nation of God. Keeping God's law and words is a way of loving God with our hearts and soul and mind. And it is also our loving our neighbors as ourselves. Last week, I asked you a question. Why isn't the book of Exodus end at the scene where they exit Egypt? Why does the story go on to God giving the laws and instructions to his people, and also further God testing them in the wilderness? Why do you think? It's because salvation, God saving his people, is both exiting from sin and training his people by his word and his instruction. Again, with both exiting from sin and being trained by God under his words throughout our entire life makes our salvation complete. Did you guys understand that? Thumbs up if you understood it. So salvation is both exiting from our sin and also being trained by God under his word. Then some of you might ask, I thought salvation is free gift, that as long as we put our faith in Jesus, then we don't have to do things. Isn't keeping God's word and obeying his word and doing all the things that he tells us to do, isn't that gaining salvation with our deeds, with our work? No, salvation is still free gift from our God, because none of us can exit the sin by ourselves, and none of us will exit the sin by once and completely forever, meaning everyone will fall to sin over and over again. And also none of us can obey God's word 100% fully through our daily lives, our everyday life. But there was one person one person on earth who fulfilled and completed God's law and God's word with a perfect obedience. And that was Jesus Christ. He had no sin, so he had no sin to exit. Jesus still obeyed and fulfilled God's word and in his will and God's word, even through all humiliation, all hatred from his people, and with knowing that he will be disconnected from God by taking everyone's sin upon him, he still fully obeyed to God's word. So us believers, by putting our faith to this Christ, God placed our punishment of death to the life of salvation, the gift of salvation. And that's why, because we receive the free gift of God through Jesus Christ, we voluntarily love and obey and cleanse ourselves to out of appreciation and love towards God who gave us the second chance. Jesus says in John 14, 15, if you love me, you will obey what I command. And what he commands is following and knowing the word of God. GSPC Junior High students, are you keeping God's instruction, God's word, God's law out of love for Christ, who was born for you and who died for you and who resurrected for you? Are you following and obeying the Ten Commandments so that you can know God better and you can love him better and you can have an intimate relationship with God? Are you joyfully submitting yourself to show your love and gratitude towards your one and only God, the one God who created you and who cared for you? In this new year of 2021, because God gave us a new year, God gave us another chance to live as a holy people of God, to know God. Let us all live out God's law and his words as you and I are God's chosen people, God's beloved people, God's cared children, and God's saved people. Amen? Amen. Let's pray. Our loving God and almighty God, we lift your name up high. Through the stories of Israel in Genesis and Exodus, we learn that you are God who judges the wicked and who leads his people and who gives and guides and saves his people. As your almighty righteous hand delivered the Israelites out of Egypt and from their slavery, we believe that your almighty hands are exiting us from our sin and bringing us closer to you. As we enter the new year of 2021, God, please help us to refocus our eyes on you. And you, as you taught us today, let us love you and love our neighbors out of our thankfulness and love towards you. Once again, I thank you for your love and grace that you pour down to us and the chance that you give us in our daily lives. We thank you. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.